Hello, welcome into this tutorial. I'll train on loops in JavaScript. You can view the full course in our website. Just to check in the description part, you'll see the link. Then we'll start. First of all, just launch our test editor. On my side, I'm using Visual Studio Code. Just come here, then you create a new file, then you can just name it as just save, then save it as. You can save it as loops. Right now, dot HTML. Right now, after that, we are just using embedded JavaScript, whereby we have a JavaScript inside an HTML file. So first generate, this is not so important. Then this is just basic part of HTML. Then you just go in between your body tags. Now you write script, and then okay, so you can close your program or JavaScript program inside script tags. Now you'll search by various types of loops, we have several types of loops in JavaScript, whereby we have for loop, we have a for in loop, then we have something else we call while loop, then we have do while loop. Now we'll discuss each, giving several or just an example to illustrate the same. First of all, we can start with while loop. Now, while loop is just used when one wishes to perform an action again and again. Its purpose is to execute a statement or a code block repeatedly as long as an expression is true. Once the expression becomes false, then the loop terminates or stops. Now, we are saying that while loop is just used when you just need to do an action or execute a block of code repeatedly again and again, Now, here, we're saying that when you're so let's say, for instance, you just need to execute numbers between 1 to 10. Then you just say, let's say you give the numbers value of x, then you just say less than 10, So now it will, the loop will iterate and run again and again as long as the value of x is less than 10. So it means that it will output numbers between 0 and 10, whereby that is 0 to 9. So it will output 0 up to 9. Right, so we can have an example here to show the same, whereby we love, let's first have an so we are discussing about while loop. Okay, let's have an syntax, a general format there. Now, this is a general format now of the while loop. Now we'll have an expression here. We'll have an expression. Then in between the curly brackets, now you have the statement to be executed. Statement to be be executed when the expression, if the expression, if the expression is true, where if the expression is true. Now, this is the general format whereby we start with while, then you have an expression here, then the statement will be executed if the expression is true. This expression now. Let's have an example here whereby we start with while, then okay, before we do that, we can have vary, whereby we define a variable. Let's say variable count, we call it 0. So then we have count. So this is a variable called count. Then we have 0 is less than 10. It's less than 10. Then we can have curly bracket there. Then we say document dot write. You can just have current number, or current count. Can I call it current count? Then you can have that one. Then you can have now. You can have count, then this is now okay. This is just a line break to show the end of the, block code, and then after that, here you just use a semicolon. Then we have now count. Okay, all right. Not that. So this is count. Now this one count, you hand an increment. Now it will be increasing with one. It means that it will increase by one. You can just say plus plus two. This means that this plus plus one. Then you can have either two, something like that. The number will be changing it after every turn, right? Now, after that, you can just go to your browser, then click there and see what appears. See now, so this is current count is 0, you have 1, 2, up to 9, because the loop will run again and again as long as the value for count is less than 10, right? Hope you understand on how you can use while loop. Now we'll do something else to do with do while loop. Now do while loop is almost the same as while loop, but in this case do-while loop is just almost the same as while loop, but in this case the condition happens, the condition check, or when testing for the condition, it happens at the end of the loop. This means that the loop will always be executed at least once, even if the condition is false. What am I meaning now? I'm saying that the condition check, or the testing of the condition, happens at the end of the loop. This means that the loop will even execute, or you'll even run, even if the condition is wrong. So let's say I have a basic format for this. So we'll start with the do. So we'll start with the do. Then okay, this one we could just this. Okay, so this is a general format for do while loop, whereby we'll have curl brackets, then we'll have the statement now to be executed, statement to be executed, right? Then at the end, if it is true, then at the end here we'll have now the expression. So we have seen that the condition checking is at the end of the loop. So this is the only difference with the while loop. Okay, so that's how it appears. So whereby we have do, then the statement to be executed, then while, then we'll have the expression. So now it means that the loop will just go once, even if it is wrong before, because the condition checking or testing is done at the end of the loop. Alright? Then if it is true, the loop continues. If it is wrong, terminate. Alright? So we can have an example here. The same example. Let's remove this one. Let's remove the comment now. We'll have here we'll remove this one, then we'll put it to develop. Then we'll have now at the end here is where now we'll have the expression, whereby we'll say count less than 10, right? Now less than 10. Let's run our program, see how it appears. Now you just go your browser here, then you just refresh. See now? So it produces the same thing. You have 0 to 9. Now that's how we are saying. That's what we are talking about here. Now you can change your values, you can change your variable name, you can change anything there, then see how it appears. Now the other thing, and very important, we'll be looking at something else we call variable initialization. Now we'll be looking at variable or what you call for loop. For loop now is very important, and there is a most common loop that is used in all the programming languages, and for the loop at three major parts, whereby the first one is variable initialization. We can have the general format whereby we'll have for, then we'll have initialization. We have test condition, then we'll have iteration statement. We'll have the iteration statement. Then after that, we'll now have the curly brackets. Then in between here, we'll have the statement to be executed now. Statement to be executed. All right. Now, if the test or if the expression is true, then what you're talking about here is that initialization is whereby you initialize our counter or starting value. You initialize the starting value of the loop. You can just say that, let's say you start from 0, if your counting numbers between 1 to 0 to 10, then you can just start at at 0, then you can that's where now that's what you call initialization, and it is executed before the loops begin, right? So this one is executed before the loop begins, right? Then the other one is test condition, whereby the test is the condition is tested whether it is true or false. If it is true, the loop continues. If it is false, then it terminates or it stops. Then the other one is iteration statement, whereby you can increase or decrease your counter or just your variable. You can either choose to increase by 1 or increase by 2, or just choose to decrease by 1 or 2 or any other value, right? So that's all. And then up now you understand the general format for the variable initialization. Now the other thing, and probably here we'll have an example to determine or to show how for loop works. Now the same example, here we'll have the var count, then here we'll have now the, okay, you can have this example here, then let's have this example whereby we love for, then in between there we love the counter. Now this is what you call initialization, to show where the counter is starting. So it is starting from 0. Now love the counter, or the count. Count is the variable name we are using here, less than 6. We can just use another number there, just to say less than 6. Then you'll say counter, and you can have it as plus. So this means, okay, this means now we are increasing by 1, right? This is decrement. Okay, then the other one here we'll have now the statement to be executed, then we'll have into bracket, you can just say the number is, then you can call it here, you can just say plus counter, right? So this plus counter, it means that the this variable name we're using here, so this is a value for counter. Now this is where we are writing it here, then we'll have now the semicolon, right? Now then the other one here we can just say document dot write, then you can just say, all right. Now what you're trying to say here, or what you're trying to mean, is that this is a break, this is a break line or line break. So it means that the number after the one loop is produced, now the result for the next loop will be produced in the following line. So this one is just use okay resource for this, this is right. So now this means that if you try to run your program, then the lines will be after each other. Now it means that after one loop or one round or iteration, it means that the next line will appear below the other. Okay, that's all about for loop. Hope you understand. Now let's run our program and see how it will appear. Now after you run, see it produces 1, 2, 5, because you see that it will run as long as it remains 2. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so With that, you have understood the three major parts of the follow-up. And lastly, in our tutorial today, we'll discuss for-in loop. For-in loop is just used to loop through object properties. This may be hard for you now, but with the time, after you just learn various objects in JavaScript, it will be easy for you. And probably it's just used to when you're accessing array elements, which where you now use now for in loop. There, for in loop is very important. And what you look here now, you can just write or you can just use for in loop. Let's say just write variable a property. Okay. So you can just come here, then just write a property, then you just say this is Safari, this is a property, then in here you just write, let's say, a property. Okay, here in between these brackets, now here love now a property in navigator, then you know document property. Now here what to do, you say now it should produce that particular properties. Now it will now output the properties of that particular web browser. Now let's run and see the outcome. Now it outputs all the properties of my device. It may output different depending on the type of the device you're using. Now you can see that probably languages, you can see something else here we call app version, you can see web, you can see keyboard managed, and probably something here important I've seen, Java enabled. See now, she's showing that Java is enabled, PDF viewer is enabled, Bluetooth, it has many properties. So this one is now producing the properties of this my PC. Now thank you guys for watching. This is LearnTech Philo. You may visit our website www.learntechphilo.com and few more of our courses. Thank you.